I'm Anita Abraham from Hyderabad, India. It was fascinating for me to read my classmates' posts on microculture and respond to it. While everyone had wonderful posts about the various microcultures in our group, I was particularly fascinated by Yafa and Khalid's microculture post and responded to it. Some of the techniques that I used while responding to their post included making sure that I understood what they were trying to say by carefully reading their post and also reflecting on it before I responded. I feel I was able to gauge the emotions connected or involved in what they were trying to present in their microculture post through their experience. I was able to share my point of view with Khalid and also request some extra additional information from Yafa to understand her context better. I hope I was able to make Khalid see things differently and encourage and also encourage a novice teacher like Yafa, because the reason that I chose Khalid and Yafa was this young teacher who's training to be a teacher, and Khalid, interestingly for me, is from Sudan, and I'm fascinated by all the experiences that he's been bringing to the class that we are to the class through the online course that we have been doing. Well, for me, the ability to reflect and think critically and listen or read actively are intertwined very deeply, and I feel that they come, and all these three concepts, be it reflection or critical thinking or listening or reading actively, complement each other, and they enhance our ability to observe and interpret better. And I feel that we become aware of alternate perspectives, which is very, very important in today's world. Intercultural competence to navigate through microcultures that we encounter every day and critical thinking are vital 21st century skills that we must impart to our students as teachers. And if we teachers become competent in understanding how to integrate it into our classrooms, it will enhance our learning environments and meet the requirements, the needs of our learners, and make them more effective and more productive in their lives, be it in their education or at their workplace. I plan to consciously work on my observation and interpretation capabilities. After going through module 3, I see the importance of using the various reflective techniques to be an effective teacher and teacher trainer. I have decided that I will reflect deeply after each of my class and each of my teacher training session, and maybe even maintain a diary, because I feel we tend to forget certain things that come to our mind after a class is over. So maybe have a diary and jot things that I thought of could have been done better, what went well, what the participants' reaction was, so that it will improve my teaching and my training sessions, and it will also help me grow as a teacher. I feel I've been able to understand the need for teachers to be effective and employ all the various techniques that was presented in the module, and I also am able to see the importance of critical thinking and active listening for both us teachers and for the learners. I'm already thinking of ways to integrate these concepts, be it critical thinking, intercultural competence, or active listening or reading, into my curriculum in college and into my teacher training modules so that it benefits the students and I'm able to cascade the new knowledge that I have learned among my colleagues. Thank you very much. This is Anita Abraham from Hyderabad, India.